I'm pretty good with a lightsaber. If I do say so myself. Hello and welcome to Crazy Movie Review. My name is Walter Glenn. And today we will be reviewing Star Wars Episode 5. Yeah. Sorry. 5. Empire Strikes Back. Yes, the Empire did strike back. And not just a little way. Big way. Big way. In a big way to where Han Solo was captured, put in carbonite, to where Princess Leia kissed her brother, not knowing that it was her brother, and in a way that Luke got his arm chopped off by his father. Yes, his father. I don't know how you guys feel about the Star Wars original trilogy, but I feel like this one, Episode 5, Empire Strikes Back, is the darkest one in the Star Wars original trilogy. Dark. Yes. Dark, very dark. Why George Lucas wanted to make this film so dark, I have no idea, but it could have something to do with Luke's destiny and becoming a Jedi Knight. And we all know that in order to become a Jedi Knight, you have to go through a number of trials. Yes. And they're not easy trials either. They are very freaking, like, on the borderline of death trials. Like, can kill you trials if you're not completely focused. In which Luke didn't seem very focused at all. He seemed like he wanted to save his friends more than complete his training with Master Yoda. The film takes off in a desolate, snowy planet called Hoth. There are a number of settings of places that this film was shot in location of, but I have no idea where those are. But from what I gathered, Hoth was one of the biggest areas ever that they probably filmed the area in. And they also filmed in an asteroid field. Who does that? Like, I don't think I would be able to take my car, if it was a flying car, to an asteroid field and I would stay there. I would not do that. No, sounds like a bad idea. But the Empire wants the princess and Han Solo is the guy to keep the princess safe. So what's he do? He makes a plan to take the princess out of the snowy planet, and he takes her to what we like to call a very, very, very bad desolate area. Like taking your first date to the ghetto for dinner. So after Luke sees the vision of Ben telling him to go to Dagobah, what does he do? He gets in his X-Wing and go to Dagobah. But after he went on the Battle of Hoth, which was with the snow speeders and the AT-AT walkers and all the harpoon locking and trapping and circling and crashing and blowing up the, you know, snowy planet. Or snowy base, whatever. He sets out to go to Dagobah with R2-D2. And here's one thing I don't ever get in the Star Wars movies. Like, how do the Rebels understand what the droids are saying? Like, can anybody answer that for me? Like, all you're making is whistles and, like, squeaky noises. Like, and, like, you'd be like, I mean, imagine taking a droid to, like, McDonald's or something. You want some fries? Like what? Well, like, I wouldn't understand what you said, because, I mean, I guess they understand what they're saying. I don't know. They're in space, so, I don't know. Anyway, so Luke finds and goes to Dagobah, and he's finding a Jedi Master, as we all know, as Yoda. Yes, Yoda. You think Yoda. Lo and behold, he finds a little bitty, creepy, weird, green midget person with a cane. Yes, everybody, that is Yoda. That's what Yoda is, and he's got pointy ears and gray hair. What 999-year-old you reach, look as good you will not. Well, he looks pretty good for a old man, or old green, whatever he is. So Han, Chewie, Leia, and C-3PO are all in the Millennium Falcon. They left Hoth in an asteroid field. Lo and behold, the asteroid field has a creature inside of it. Or they landed on an asteroid field, and they went inside the cave, which they thought was a cave, but it was actually a creature's mouth. But the special and visual effects in this movie were, I'd have to say they were pretty good. They weren't bad. The snow monster, the Yeti, whatever you want to call him, looked like a big, big, big creepy bear. You know. So the Millennium Falcon is still getting hunted by the Empire, and they still want Leia the Princess. So Han decides he's going to call a buddy of his, Lando Calrissian, yeah. Well, he didn't call him, he just, like, you know, was trying to figure out a, you know, good place to hide. So he's like, let's go to Cloud City. My best friend Lando Calrissian lives there. So they ended up going to Cloud City. Little did we know that his best friend would betray him. The Empire got there right before he did. So, anyway, Darth Vader gets them, captures them. Leia's captured, Chewie's captured, everyone's captured. But the torture scenes, I actually enjoyed those, actually. Especially Han's torture scene. That was the icing on the cupcake for me. I kind of enjoyed that. I know that sounds kind of weird, but it's kind of cool. Very dark. So Luke senses that his friends are in trouble and he does not want to complete his training. He thinks he has learned a lot from Master Yoda and he wants to test out his new abilities on the Empire, who are currently in Cloud City, which I have no clue how he knew they were there. Like, did he use the Force and be like, Ben, tell me where they are? And Ben's like, they're in Cloud City, Luke. They're in Cloud City. He's like, I'm headed to Cloud City. Well, the two former Jedi Masters, Obi-Wan, Yoda, don't want Luke to go because they don't want him to fall like his father did. Because he's just like a, you know, like a Jedi learner. So, you know, of course he would give in to any kind of anger because he doesn't know how to control it yet. Or at least we thought, or so. But anyway, so Luke goes there, confronts his father, and they fight. Little did he know that he was going to get his arm chopped off. Because he let his guard down, yes. Never let your guard down when sword fighting with a bad guy, guys. Or a Sith Lord, per se. So, Leia, Lando, and Chewie try to get Han back from the bounty hunter. By the way, Han Solo was tortured, and he was placed in a little carbonite chamber, and boom. He was put into carbonite, because he owes money to Jabba the Hutt, and the bounty hunter was going to give him to Jabba the Hutt so he could get money. So basically, Jabba owns Han Solo now. So they're going to try to rescue him, but their efforts kind of don't go so well. But anyway, so Luke's in trouble. He gets his arm chopped off. His father tells him, or Darth Vader tells him that he's his father. He goes down in a little pit or whatever, and he basically, like, is on the bottom of Cloud City hanging on for dear life with one arm. So he reaches out with the Force and calls his sister. Little did we know Leia was his sister. And they go back and get Luke.
They rescue Luke. They go back to the Rebel, you know, Rebel space station. Blah, 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 blah. Lando and Chewie are gonna go rescue Han. They have a plan. And that's where we leave for episode 6. So, I hope you guys have learned something from this review. If you're training to be a Jedi, don't quit because your friends are in trouble. Alright, maybe you don't want to do that. But, you know, if there's any type of way you can save your friends without them being tortured and sold to Jabba the Hutt, then, you know, I guess risk it. But just don't get your arm chopped off in the process by your father, or your nemesis, or Sith Lord. So, I hope you've enjoyed this crazy movie review. And there are more to come, guys. More to come. So stay tuned. And this is Walter, a.k.a. Crazy March Kids, signing off. I bid you good day.